In this video, I'm going to go over text split function in Excel and cases where you can actually use this. So let's start with a basic example here. So if I have this text right here, if I wanted to split this text to multiple columns using this comma separator, I could just point to this text, comma, and then use a delimiter in quotes as a comma, like so, close parentheses, hit enter, and that should split this using these commas, as you can see, to four different columns. And then I could take this and drag this formula down, and we're gonna get the results for each row. So once we split it by a comma, for example, if you look right here, we have this comma, and then we have this space and apple. So right now, our second column is going to be this, space and apple, instead of just being apple. So if you wanted to remove those extra spaces, you could go back here and add trim function around this whole thing. And that should eliminate those extra spaces. You can see here how I have apple now more to the left because we just removed that space compared to grapes and carrots. Now, if I drag this formula down, it's also gonna fix the rest for me. Now, I want to note the fact that when you use this function, the results you get here are text. So this 199 is not number 199, it's text. So all the column results you get here are actually text. So if that's something you wanna take care of, you could do that as well. And what we could do here, we could simply just go back and use something like let function to store this result in a variable. I'm gonna call it separated array. You can call this variable anything you want. Then we'll run this to get our results. We can now take this separated array, and if we take that and add zero to it, it will basically try to add zero and see if it's able to do so. So if I close parentheses right now and hit enter, you'll see that what happens here, for numbers and dates, it's able to actually do that calculation, and it's not able to do that for these other text calculations here. So what we can do, we can go back here and put this calculation inside of an if error function. And we can say, let's try to do this. And if there is an error, let's just return the results as they used to be. So I'll just do separated array. I'll close parentheses for this if error function. And at this point, if I'd enter and drag it down, you'll see that we get our results. So we get these as text. This is a number. This is a date, just no formatting. So if I go here and do short date, you'll see that we're able to actually now create valid dates, numbers, and text from splitting our data. So let's go over a few other examples. Let's say we have a list of names. So a very basic example here would be to again use something like text split and then point to this text and then separate it with a space in quotes. So delimiter right now is gonna be the space in the middle. If I'd enter, we'll see how we can split first and last names to their own separate columns. Now that can get a little more complicated if we have to do it here. So if I try to do text split, point to this, and then split it by a space, and then I try to drag this down, well, because we have this middle initials in some of these cases, then we split it to three columns, like so. So what if we want to just get first and last name, we wanna basically not have this middle initials in the middle. So what we could do, we could basically grab a particular word from this result. So for example, if I take this and add columns function around it, hit enter and drag it down, you'll see that what I get here is the number of columns that are created after we split that by a space. So for this one, we have two words, so we got two column results, then three, then two, then three. So if we could use this and get only the first word and this last word, which is this 2, 3, 2, whatever number that is, that should give us first and last names from this. So now let's try to do so. So I'm gonna go back here to just text split for a second. Drag this down for the time being. So for example, if I wanted to get the first word only now, I could go here and add a function choose columns, this function, and provide this array. And then here after comma, if I just do one, close parentheses and hit enter and drag it down, it's gonna only give us the first word. Now, if I wanted to get the second word, I can go here and do two and drag it down. And you can see we got now the second word. Now, what I want to do, I want to actually get the first word. And then what we can do a comma and actually give it another column position. So if I do one and two, then it's gonna give us this first and second word. Then I can go here and do comma three. But what I actually want, I want this second one to be the last word. So instead of hard coding two, I want to basically just grab the last word out of it. And the way we can do that, we can grab this text split function again. And instead of this two, we can just do columns and paste that text split function in it. If you remember what this does, it counts how many columns we have. And that number is always gonna be the last column number. So if I hit enter and drag this down, now we'll get this, basically first and last word. So if you only wanted the last word, you could just remove this one and comma, and that should only give us the last word from that particular text. Now, I want the first one too, so I'm gonna do one comma this. Now, we can make this a little more efficient by not repeating this same thing twice in our formula. So I can go before this and store this in a variable using let function. So I can do let, call this words, comma, and I'm gonna paste that function, comma. And then after that, in this calculation, instead of doing this, I can simply just use that variable words here and one more time words here too. And that way we only do this text split calculation once in our formula. I do need another close parentheses to finish this let function. So if I had enter and drag it down, it should give us exactly the same results. So finally, let's look at the other couple of arguments that are available in TEXTSPLIT. So if you look here, we have this date, comma, then we have the words, comma, then number, and then there's a semicolon, and it goes to the next date. So this whole thing is a single line. And basically, there is a semicolon that separates each record in this particular line, and then we have commas that separate the columns. So you can say that this semicolon is the row separator and this commas are columns separators. I'm gonna make this column smaller. So what I can do here, I can use that text split and point to this data, comma, and then as a column delimiter, I can use comma, and then comma again, and as a row delimiter, we can use a semicolon, close parentheses, and hit enter. And you can see how we take this one cell with text and we split it like this to multiple rows and columns based on those separators. Now you could also have situations when your cells look like this. So there's no like semicolon here, but there's a new line separating these lines. And you want to split this in the same fashion. So I can go here and do text split. And again, I'm gonna point to this comma as a column we're going to use that comma as a delimiter again, comma again. And as a row delimiter, we're going to use a space. And the way we can do a space, we'll do quotation. And as a space, I'm going to do Alt Enter or Option Enter if you're on a Mac, close quotation. So now my separator here is this new line. And I'm going to close parentheses and hit Enter. And you'll see how that works pretty much the same way. Now, you may also want to take care of those spaces before and after your words and make sure that these are actually numbers and dates, which currently aren't. And you can tell by just looking at the alignment. See how everything is aligned to the left? And just to prove that these are not numbers, I'm going to go ahead and try to do something like sum. And you'll see that we get a zero. So at this point, if I go here and trim this, close parentheses and hit enter, it will remove those extra spaces. But I want to now convert these two numbers and these two dates. So again, we can use that trick I did before. So I'm going to store this in a variable. I'll do let data, comma, to be equal this. I'll go after that and do a comma. And then what we're going to do, we're going to do if error. And we'll try to basically convert it to a number. So we'll take that data and add zero to it. And if it fails, comma, we'll just use data. Close parentheses one more time for that let function, hit enter. And now these are numbers and you can see how this sum started working because these are actually numbers. And if you want to convert this to a date, you can. And now we have proper dates and proper numbers in our data. Finally, I want to go over those last couple of arguments we have here in text split. And for that, let's just go to a basic split. So as a column delimiter, we'll use a comma. And as a row delimiter, we'll use that Alt Enter or Option Enter to create a new line. In quotes, close parentheses, hit enter just to get back to this. Now, if I go back to this function, right here, see there's this ignore empty and this padding arguments that we didn't use. So first, let's talk about that ignore empty. So let's say in this original text, we have a new line here. I'm going to do that option enter again to add a new line. So you can see how when I have that new line, now we have another row here. And then we have a bunch of NAs because there's nothing here to split with a comma. Now you might want to ignore that empty line. And the way you can do so is by going here and adding a comma. And when it says ignore empty cells, we can say true. And if I enter, you'll see that's gone. So the default behavior is false, which if you don't do anything, is the same as doing false here. So I can go back and do true. So that's the reason you may need that parameter if you decide you want to use that. And then finally, there's this pad, which is the last parameter. Now, what that does, in this particular example, every row with split ends up getting exactly the same number of columns. But let's say I go here and I remove this last couple of things here. And we have just grapes and we have the date, but the rest is not there. So if I hit enter, you'll see that these are gonna get NAs because there's nothing. And this is where we can pad this with some different values. So whatever you use after comma here, so if I just say hi, see it's gonna just basically fill those cells with that text. Now, if you want them to be blanks, you can just do double quotes. Like so, and there we are. And those are your last two arguments here in this text split function. So hopefully that covers everything you need to know about this. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.